Hello everyone, okay, welcome to this video on gap and difference. Okay, so in this video, I'm going to show you three different methods on how we can solve problems like this. Okay, usually this type of problem will have left-left, short-short, left-short, short-left, you know, so we can use this strategy called gap and difference. Okay, before that, what are the three different methods that I usually teach students? Systematic listing, model drawing and formula. Okay, so usually I will teach all these three methods and let the students choose which method they like best. Okay, let's look at a sample question. Ahmad has some sweets to distribute to his students. If he gives each student 5 sweets, he will have 4 sweets left. If he gives each student 7 sweets, he will be short of 16 sweets. How many sweets does he have? Okay, so basically the question says, give 5 each, 4 sweets left. Give 7 sweets each, short of 16. So this is a left and short question. Okay, so how to find the number of sweets that Ahmad has? So we have to find the number of students first. So let's look at how to use the first method, which is systematic listing. Okay, so from the word systematic listing, so basically what we will do is to list down systematically, okay, the number of students and the number of sweets that Ahmad will have. Okay, and then we will look for the one that is the same. So for example, if there's one student and Ahmad give each student 5 sweets, that means 1 times 5, he will have 4 sweets left plus 4. Okay, so if there's one student, then Ahmad will have 9 sweets. If there's two students, Ahmad will have 2 times 5, 10 plus 4, 14 sweets. If there are three students, Ahmad will have 3 times 5, 15 plus 4 sweets, 19 sweets. Okay, so this is from the first condition. How about from the second condition? If he gives each student 7, that means times 7, he will be short of 16, so minus 16. Now, if there's only one student, 1 times 7 is 7. Can 7 minus 16? No. So it's impossible to have one student. How about two students? 2 times 7 is 14. 14 minus 16 is 2. Here, there are 14 sweets, and here there's 2 sweets. So 2 students is not the answer. How about 3 students? 3 times 7 is 21, and 21 minus 16 is 5. Okay, so again, 3 students is not the answer. So in this systematic listing method, what we have to do is to list down systematically until we get the answer. Okay, and this is a slow and tedious process. Okay, so since I know the answer, I'm going to cheat. Okay, I'm going to tell you 10 students. Let's say for example there are 10 students. 10 times 5, 50 plus 4 is 54. 10 times 7, 70 minus 16 is also 54. Okay, so there are 10 students and how many sweets does Ahmad have? He has 54 sweets. So this is the systematic listing method. Okay, so if you are given 5 sweets each times 5, left 4 means plus 4. If you are given 7 sweets each times 7, short of 16 means minus 16. Okay, so you list down based on the number of students and then you look for the number that is the same, and that will be the answer. Okay, how about the model drawing method? Let's look at the model drawing method. Okay, so for the model drawing method, let's start with the smaller number, which is 5 sweets. So we do not know the number of students which we want to find, right? So let's say each student get 5 sweets. 5, 5, 5. Okay, and this will continue. Okay, we do not know how many students are there. So I will just put dot dot dot. Okay, but if Ahmad give each student 5 sweets, there will be 4 sweets left. So there will be 4 sweets extra. Okay, so now the second condition, he gives each student 7 sweets. Okay, so 7 sweets, what does that mean? That means each student now will get extra 2 sweets. Okay, that is how each student now will have 7 sweets. So let's make use of the extra 4 sweets just now to distribute to the students that are going to get 7 sweets each. So now each student will get extra 2, right? So how many students will get extra 2? Because they are left 4 sweets, so 2 students will get extra 2 more sweets to make 7 sweets. And then if he tries to continue giving 2 sweets more to each student, what happened? He doesn't have enough sweets. Because the question says, if he gives each student 7, he will have short of 16. That means the rest, okay, he's not able to give extra 2 sweets. And he's short of 16 sweets. Only if he has that 16 sweets, then he's able to give each student extra 2 sweets. Okay? So do you understand the model? So if he gives each student extra 5 sweets, he'll be left with 4. If he gives each student 7, so we make use of the extra 4 sweets, give each student extra 2, we will find that only 2 students will get extra 2 sweets. The rest will not get. Okay, because why? He is short of 16. So can you see from the model that if we add the 16 and the 4 together, okay, 16 plus 4, we will get 20. Okay, and when we take 20 divided by 2, we will get the number of students. Okay, so there are 10 students. So once we get the number of students, we can make use of the condition to find the number of sweets. So from the first condition, if there are 10 students, each student get 5, there will be extra 4. So there are 54 sweets. And from the second condition, 10 students, each student gives 7. If he gives 7 to each student, then he'll be short of 16. So 10 times 7, 70 minus 16 is also 54 sweets. So confirm our answer is correct. Okay? So in this type of question, we are double if and there are 2 conditions. You can always check your answer and make sure that it's confirmed correct. Okay? So this is the model drawing method. Okay, but my favorite method is the formula method. In 4 steps, you will get the answer. Okay, so let's look at how to apply the gap and difference method. Okay, so for the formula method, what we do? Okay, so for the formula method, okay, first we need to identify what is the gap. So basically, what does gap mean? Gap means the difference between the short and the left. Okay, so if it is short left, that means different, right? They are traveling in the opposite direction. What you have to do to find the gap, you have to add them up. Okay, so imagine left 4, short of 16. Okay, so what is the gap? So the gap will be 20. Understand? So the difference is always minus. Okay, the difference is the change. So from 5 becomes 7. So what is the difference? So the difference is 2. This is the formula, okay, that we need to use for gap and difference method. To get the number of students, we need to take the gap divide by the difference. And this will give us the formula. So here the gap is 20. And the difference is 2. So there will be 10 students. And once we get the number of students, it's easy, okay, to find the number of sweets. Okay, we can use any of the condition above. 10 students, 5 students each, 5 sweets each, 4 sweets left. So 10 times 5, 50 plus 54. So that will be the answer. How do we check? We use the second condition. If there are 10 students and each student gets 7 sweets, there will be 16 sweets short. So 70 minus 16 is 54. So we can confirm that our answer is correct. Okay? So this is the 3 methods that we can use to solve gap and difference word problems. Now, what if the question does not give us short left or left short? What if it's left left? Or short short, what do we do? Okay, so for example, let me just change the numbers. Okay, so let's say if he gives each student 5 sweets, he will have 4 sweets left. But if he gives each student 3 sweets, he will have, if he gives each student 2 sweets, he will have 34 sweets left. Okay, so now it's left. Okay, so now it's left, same direction. So what do we do? Okay, so for the formula method, to find the gap, if it's in the same direction, left or short, we have to minus. So 34 minus 40 minus 4 is 30. And the difference will be the same, which is 5 minus 2. So the change is 3. To find the number of students, what do we have to do? We have to take the gap, divide by the difference. Okay, so here we will get 30 divided by 3. So there are 10 students. How to find the number of sweets? Just use any of the conditions given. So let's say there are 10 sweets. Each student is given 5 sweets. There will be 4 sweets left. So 10 times 5 plus 4 is 54. How do we check? Okay, let's say we use the other condition. If there are 10 students, each student receives 2 sweets. So 10 times 2 is 20. There will be 34 sweets left. So 20 plus 34 is also 54. So we can confirm that our answer is correct. Okay, so here we need to take note that if it is in the same direction, so left 4 and left 34, what is the gap? Okay, so here the gap we have to minus. 34 minus 4 is 30. Okay, so this method is very easy. Okay, if you understand how to use it. Okay, let me just end the video by showing the model for the left word problem. So let's say if you want to use the model method, let's begin with the smaller one, which is 2. So if each student is given 2 sweets, we do not know the number of students at first, there will be 34 sweets left. So there will be 34 sweets left. Now, if each student is given 5 sweets, what is the change? So basically now, each student will be given extra 3 more. Okay, because now they will have 5. So we have 34, right? So 34 after giving each student 3 sweets. Okay, that means we have more than enough. Okay, even the last student will get 3 sweets more. And then what happened? There will be 4 sweets left. Okay, so from the model, can you see how many sweets were used to give the students 3 more extra sweets? So it's 34 minus 4. So 30 sweets were given to the students. And each student gets extra 3 sweets. So if each student gets extra 3 sweets, that means there are 10 students. So once you get the number of students, you can use the same method to find the number of sweets. Okay, so my advice is try to learn and understand all the 3 different methods, because you will never know which method, okay, you will need to use during exam. So thank you for watching and all the best.